Well, praise the Lord, friends, for this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Good morning, happy Sunday, people of God. This is the day that we celebrate and give thanks. It is the third Sunday of Advent, the third Sunday of us expecting the coming of Jesus Christ. Let us move into our call to worship. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. Our joy is in the Lord who blesses us. Shout for joy, for the Lord is near. Our praises ascend to God for the mighty things God has done. Let your praise dance and swirl in tribute to God. Surely God blesses and saves us. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Our first song is a very familiar song on the season of wonderful expectations of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. If you know it, please join along with me. O come, all ye faithful. Prayer time, and we truly believe in the power of prayer. At this time is one of the most important times of our service, where we can cast all of our cares unto God. for we have someone who careth for us. At this time, let us go to God in prayer. But before we go to God in prayer, I want you to spend some alone time with God. For the next 30 seconds between you and God, I want you to tell the Lord everything that's on your heart. Cast all your prayer requests to Him. This is your time. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we come to you thanking you for everything that you do for us, thanking you for being so good to us. We ask you for your complete forgiveness today. Please forgive us for all the wrong we've done and cleanse us from the inside out. Bless us, Lord, like never before. Touch each and every person who's listening to the sound of my voice. I pray that you will give them joy and hope today. I pray you will give them reassurance, Lord. I ask if you would just continue to bless us as we rejoice to you for everything that you have done for us in our lives. We ask if you will continue to make a way for us and lift us up like we've never been lifted. We love you more than anything, and we adore you, God. The Lord, we do not want to conclude this prayer without praying the prayer that you taught us to pray. Starting now. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in his only Son, Jesus Christ, my Lord, conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead, ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting.
And find out there is none like.
God bless you on today. Now it's time for the Word of God. Our scripture reading today comes from Hebrews chapter number 1, chapter number 11, verses 1. Hebrews chapter number 11, verse 1. Very familiar passage of scripture. It simply says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Amen. For a few moments of your time, I want to preach from the simple subject, I gotta get it back. I gotta get it back. Friends, on today, when we deal and talk about faith, I truly believe that things that we go through in life can sometimes move us away from being spiritually filled with faith. Now, friends, on today, I want to let you know that in every area of life, we utilize faith. I mean, in reality, just think about your own life. When you sat in the seat that you're sitting in now, you didn't check to make sure that what none of the legs broke. You just trusted that when you sat down, the seat would hold you. I just want to let you know, you utilize faith. You remember the last time you went to a restaurant? When you went into the restaurant, you just sat in the dining room and you ordered your food. You didn't go back to the kitchen to see if the cooks were cooking it correctly. You just utilized faith, sat there and ate your food and enjoyed the time. Friends, on today, I just want to let you know, in every area of life, we utilize faith. But sometimes when life weighs us down, sometimes when life gets difficult for us, sometimes it's hard to believe. It's hard to believe sometimes when we're struggling in life that God is with us and that God will provide. We are faith people, but I truly believe sometimes in these day and ages that we live, sometimes our spiritual faith can disappear. And with that said, it brings me to my title on this morning, which simply is, I Gotta Get It Back. And that's my encouragement on this morning to someone who's struggling with spiritual faith, with believing that God is going to do something about our situation. I know it's hard and rough. Every day we wake up to something new that's negative. But in spite of what we wake up to, we gotta get it back. We have to truly believe that God is with us, that God is on our side, and that God will literally be there no matter what. That's utilizing faith. And I'm just so reminded of what the Hebrew writer says on today in Hebrews 11, chapter number 1. Matter of fact, the writer gives us the foundation of faith. He gives us a pure definition of what faith is. And sometimes while we're living in this world, sometimes while we're distracted by what we see culturally, what we see in every area of our lives, Sometimes our faith can fade, and it's up to us to get it back. Friends, on today, we have to have spiritual faith. The first reason why we have to have spiritual faith is to keep our sanity. Because if we rely on anything else to give us hope, we're in a bad place. Because the only thing in life that can give us hope is our spiritual faith in God. Because hope and faith works together. Hope and faith works cohesively in the spiritual realm of our lives. That's why the Hebrew writer says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. In other words, the writer tells us in life, we all hope for something. We all want something. And think about what you want. Think about what you're hoping for. And in reality, I must be honest with you on today, and let's not get it confused and twisted on our own personal pleasures and wants. I'm speaking about what God promises us in the Word of God. There's so many wonderful insights within this Bible that God promises us that should give us hope and should put a smile on our face. And faith in God is literally believing that everything that God says in this Bible will come to truth, will happen for us in our lives. But I want to be honest with you on today. Do you really believe that? Do you really believe that everything that the Lord says in the Word is going to happen? Well, that's where you must ask your question, you ask yourself that question and have your own litmus test. And ask your own self, do I believe it or do I need to get it back? Because the only way that you can be happy in this life is if you truly, truly, truly believe that whatever God says is going to happen. That's the thing that keeps us moving in life. That's the thing that continues to put a smile on our face when we recognize for ourselves that whatever the Lord says to us is going to happen. Friends, I'm a faith talker. I'm not only just a faith talker, but I am a faith walker. Because I believe in everything that God says. I believe that everything that God does, I believe that God is going to make a way even in times like these. And you're wondering, why would you preach about faith while we're dealing with the expectancy of Christ? Because in reality, this is a joyful time. This is a time of happiness. This is a time of good cheer. But I've spoken to so many people who live in our community. And right now, they're not full of good cheer and hope because of what's going on in their life. And I need to encourage everyone, if we're going to receive good hope and cheer and love during this season, we got to get our spiritual faith back. We got to learn how to spiritually believe that God is who He is. And God is going to do what God said He's going to do. So I want to encourage somebody today with our sermon to be of good cheer, remain faithful, remain hopeful in God, because with God in your life, you can achieve greatness and have joy. But in order for that to happen, your faith must be excellent. Your spiritual faith must be intact. Before you do anything else in life, before you do anything else on today, I need you to pray to God that he gives you your faith in him back, that he strengthens your faith, that he lets you know that whatever he said he's going to do, I promise you he's going to do it. God bless you. Bless you on today. Thank you for joining us in our worship. Remember on today, no matter what goes on, don't ever lose your faith. You got to get it back. I'm here for you. We're praying for you. We believe in you. Now unto him that's able to keep us from falling. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the love of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. Let every heart say, amen.